If you respect as your mother, he comes as your mother and protects you. If you think Swami is your grandson, he comes in that form. Just like that, he satisfies our desires and he responds to our prayers. I have a few experiences. While I attend for bhajans and all that in Mandir, daily we go there. It's almost learning so many things going to school. Bhajan session, twice bhajan and morning bhajan, evening bhajan, morning darshan and evening darshan. We learn so many things there. If we sit and silently observe Swami's gestures and people who wait there for Swami, that's the biggest learn and so many experiences we can observe there. So one day I was sitting in the line. Swami didn't come. All people were waiting for Swami. And then Swami was coming in the line. When Swami is coming in the line, if we concentrate the whole, our concentration towards Swami, it must be towards Swami. Then only we can get some vibrations or some messages from Swami. If anywhere is equal to sitting in the mandir. So just like that, one day I was sitting in the mandir, then Swami was coming. I heard Swami saying, "Neeku buddhi ledu." That means you don't have common sense. That's what he said. I couldn't understand why Swami said like that. Whenever Swami says anything, I go to Ganesha and I inquire myself whether what mistake I committed that morning or throughout the day. So I thought, what is the thing that happened in the morning? I straight away came to the darshan in the morning. There's no time to commit mistake also. So I started inquiring myself. Then I found out that some message was coming in the TV and Swami was giving his discourse. That being Thursday, he was giving his discourse. Then he was telling in the discourse, if you are angry, you scold yourself, don't scold others. That is the sentence Swami, I heard through his discourse. But I never paid any attention to that. Straight away came to darshan. That day I was so restless because the ceremony didn't come. So I was so restless and I was scolding herself because she is taking so many leaves in the month. That's the message for me. When I came to darshan, Swami gave me that message. Don't scold anybody. If you're angry, you scold yourself. That was the message I got that day. So just like that, whenever Swami wanted to convey something to us, he gives us through messages, sometimes through books, sometimes through persons who come to our house, and sometimes these cats and rats also. One cat used to come to our house daily. My husband is allergic to cats. So when he is not there in the house, that cat used to come to my house. And then I used to feed that cat. So many messages I got through cat also. And he used to criticize me and he used to make fun of me. Because so many cats are coming to the house, you are entertaining them unnecessarily. One of my friends told, don't give anything to the cat. If you can pamper and you can give something to the dog, but don't entertain that cat and don't allow it to come to the house. But I never, I didn't find any difference in that. That cat used to come there and I used to give little milk. That time I was reading one book. In that book, the one Chinese lady, she used to keep some milk near the altar. And after some time, she found out that the level of the milk was going down. And she was shocked and then she could understand that Swami used to take that milk. The milk which was kept near the altar. I thought, no, I didn't believe that. After some time, I read in Kasturiji's book. So his wife also used to keep one tumbler of milk for Swami near the altar. One day, Kasturiji went to Swami and Swami told him, today the milk is very hot. I couldn't take that milk. This man, he couldn't understand anything. He doesn't know that his wife is keeping milk near the altar. So he came home and he asked his wife. Then she said, no, I am keeping little milk for Swami. So then he could understand that whatever is kept before the altar, that also goes to Swami. That means the level of the milk was going down here also. So from that time onwards, observing the experiences of Kasturiji's wife and some other Chinese ladies experience, I started keeping some milk near the altar. So that's how it went on for some time. In the beginning, I couldn't understand Swami is coming and he is taking the milk in the form of a cat. For some days, it went on like that. One day, one lady is there, she was the principal of some college, I think. She used to stay there in Prashanthi Nilayam. She asked me to write one article. So I thought, no, if Swami tells me something, I can write. Otherwise, on my own, I cannot write anything, I said. She gave me 6 days, 1 week time. 6 days passed. That was the last day. I was cooking. I was cutting the vegetable, and then this cat came. I gave the milk and drank it and went away. Suddenly, I got flash of thoughts continuously. I could write the article then and there itself. So Swami used to inspire me through so many objects like that. And another day, the jasmine flower, I put usually the flowers, we decorate, you know, all these photographs. No, that day also, I decorated with one chrysanthemum garland. So my friend is there. She likes decorating all the altars and all that. So that day she made thick garland. And bhajan was going on. She invited me there. So I also went to attend the bhajan. The garland was dancing like anything. There was no fan also. I thought, what is it? Why this garland is dancing like that according to the tune of the bhajan? I was shocked. And then after Arati, I came home. Suddenly, I could write one poem about this garland. About the garland, that chrysanthemum garland was there. And about that garland, I could write some poem. So just like that, sometimes Swami used to inspire me to write poems. Like that one day, before Ladies' Day Festival, every 19th, there in Prashanthi Nilayam, you must be knowing, all the ladies will celebrate that Ladies' Day on 19th. That day, so many ladies were there. Swami was distributing the saris. So many VIPs from Madras, cinema actors and playback singers, so many people came there. All were sitting there. I was sitting in my original place. And Swami was in the veranda and he was calling one by one according to the list. Mrs. Shuri was holding the list. And so she's telling and she's sending the people to Swami. One by one, these people are going. Looking at that scene, I thought I could write one beautiful poem about saris and these ladies. That also I got inspiration from Swami. Karunantarangude kadali vachi, Karunantarangude kadali vachi, Komalanganala rammani piluva, Saha saundariya sarasijachulu, Paruna Swami darijera, Idugo susila saundariya anchu, Varada hastala vastrala niche, Mugdhala momuna mudamukparagan. That is the poem. See, this compassionate and kind and loving Lord, when he is calling these ladies, these beautiful, tender ladies, they are running towards Swami so that they won't miss namaskar and the sari. That's the meaning of that. According to their complexion, Swami was distributing the saris. He was selecting the sari and he was giving the sari. See, usually, Swami, whenever he gives any sari, that suits all the persons, all the ladies, even though they are not fair, it suits them like anything. There won't be any difference. Whoever wears the sari given by Swami, it will be wonderful and beautiful. So that day it was going on. The beautiful scene, all the people, all their husbands also were watching this scene. Swami was distributing the saris. I was sitting in the line, and then I thought I would get the sari. I was waiting for my name to be called, but they didn't call. They didn't call me. So I was just watching. Swami came there, and he looked at whether I am feeling jealous of these people who got the saris. He was teasing me like anything. But I could balance myself. I never showed my expression. So silently I went away. After some time, in the evening I think, then my husband came there. Swami asked him, did your wife get the sari? Then he said, no, her name is not in the list. She didn't get the sari, Swami said. My husband said to Swami. Then Swami said, no, I already sent the sari. You didn't get it? Like that Swami asked. That day what happened? No, I was sitting in the line. Swami came there and he gave the sari to the lady next to me. He looked at me, purposefully avoided and went away. I thought, why Swami is doing like this? I couldn't understand the meaning. See, so many times we cannot understand the meanings of Swami's words or Swami's gestures also. He says something at each stage we cannot understand. We have to think and rethink about it. That's my personal experience. One day he said, I was in the line again. He was coming in the line. He said, Ni mogudito uregu. That means you go along with your husband. What is it? Why Swami is telling like that? I couldn't understand the meaning. After 10 years, I could understand the meaning of the Swami's words. That means after 10 years, I started accompanying my husband wherever he goes. And whatever service I can do, I was also participating in that. That was the thing. Beforehand, Swami's plan will be 10 years ahead. We cannot understand Swami's words. So that day he purposefully avoided me. He didn't give me the sari. Afterwards, he sent through my husband. Usually, Swami used to send the sari through my husband only. But I never got, only once or twice in the line I got the sari. That's how he observes us, whether how will be our feelings. So whether somebody got the sari, these people will be jealous of them, or how they feel. That's what every moment, our facial gestures, our inner feelings, everything will be observed by Swami. That is my personal experience. And at one time, I wrote one book in Telugu and kept it near the altar. That being Ganesh Chaturthi, usually whenever we celebrate Ganesh Chaturthi, all the books of our children and our office papers and also, we keep it there. So just like that, I kept the book there. And then next morning, I went to Darshan. Whole day, the book was there near Swami's altar. Next day, I went to Darshan. I took the book also to get it blessed by Swami. Then Swami came to me and then he said, you gave the book already, why did you bring it again? I couldn't understand the meaning. Why Swami is telling this? The first time I am bringing the book to the mandir. Then I could understand that even if we keep anything near the altar, that will be blessed by Swami. So at another time, for a few days, I had an opportunity to cook for Swami. Usually, I cook for Swami. So that day, I thought of doing some item, and when I went near the stove, the total program is changed. I thought making upma, and I made this. Suddenly, I don't know how I got the idea. That is Swami's idea. So I sent this item. After that, I could learn that Swami, somebody's birthday. That day was somebody's birthday. So upma is changed into kheer. So, one day I was sitting in the line holding the letter. Then Swami came in the line. I gave the letter. He took the letter and I was about to take Pada Namaskar. Then Swami said, why you are taking Pada Namaskar daily? Why do you want Namaskar now? Swami said like that. That also I couldn't understand. Then I thought something must be there. Some inner meaning is there in that. Daily before coming to Darshan, I touch the feet of Swami's photograph and then come to Darshan. So Swami must have meant it. I thought like that. So slowly, and everything he used to teach me and he used to guide me. So many things, all that we cannot learn from outside, or nobody will tell us also. So that's how Swami guides us, Swami teaches us how to conduct ourselves in the family, how to treat guests, how to treat any person who comes to our house, just like that he used to tell me. One day one lady came to my house. All these are personal and all minor things, but there is a greater meaning in that. One lady came to my house. She was worried very much about her son, because they spent lakhs of rupees and sent him to US. So he was in the computer field. Halfway, he came back, discontinued his studies and came back to India. She was worried very much, because so much money is involved in that. She came to my husband and she was asking for the advice, what to do, how to send him back again to US. That was her problem. Continuously, she came to my house for 3 days. I was so restless. Why this lady is coming to my house and daily crying? I don't like anybody coming to our house, crying in the house. Means we feel somehow we don't like that. So that's what was going on. I never talked to her. So that was the mistake I did. That day when I went to Darshan, Swami didn't look at me. He turned that side and went away. Daily Swami will smile at me. What happened to Swami today? He never looked at me. That's how I started inquiring myself. I could find out that I made a mistake, that without, I didn't respect her, I didn't offer even a tumbler of water or coffee. So Swami must have disturbed. I thought like that. And then from that time onwards, next day when she came, I gave her coffee and I talked to her. I could understand her problem. So she was so happy. That day Swami smiled at me very nice. Immediate response from Swami. Whatever good, if it is good response. If it is something hurting anybody, that's all. Immediately he will give that dose also. See, Thursday I'll make dahi vada and sweet for Swami. So I used to send like that. My husband will take the carrier to Swami. He used to dine with Swami for 3 or 4 years here. A doubt in the beginning whether Swami is taking this or not, simply I am making. That was the doubt. So Swami clarified my doubt. See, one day I saw Ganesha appeared in the vision, and this mouth portion was completely smeared with curd. Then I could understand Swami is taking my, whatever I am sending, Swami is enjoying that. And on another day I found out that in the flame Swami appeared. I couldn't understand the meaning. Then one of my friends was there. I went and there I asked her. Then she told me, you are doing Yajna. Yajna Purusha appeared in the vision. Yajna Purusha means whatever he is taking, all that is offered to him. So Swami is taking that, why are you worried? She told me. That's how the other doubt also was clarified. So these, just like this, Swami used to tell me, Swami used to give me so many messages. At one time, my sister is in US. Her third daughter's marriage is fixed. Suddenly it got fixed. And she wrote a letter to me to buy all the saris and all that. And arrange everything. And I can send it through somebody to US. That time it took 1 month completely for me to buy the saris and matching blouses, pure silk saris, cotton saris, all varieties for the wedding. But in my hearts of hearts, I was worried that I'm wasting my time. So this time, usually I've in that leisure time, I'll use it for reading or writing something. Today I was doing that. So in between, Swami told me one poem. కొత్త కోక ఏటంచు కులికెడు నొక కోడలమ్మ కొత్త కోక ఏటంచు కులికెడునొక కోడలమ్మ కలికి తురాయి సహనము నీ సొమ్ము కఠిన శిల కరిగించు కరుణ నీదని నమ్ము ఓ కనక మహాలక్ష్మి ఇది మీ అత్త స్వానుభవం. ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద పోయిమ్ ఇస్ లైక్ దిస్. వన్ డాటర్ ఇలా కేమ్ టు హర్ మదర్ ఇలాస్ హౌస్. షీ వోర్ ఎ న్యూ శారీ అండ్ షీ వాస్ డాన్సింగ్ ఇన్ ఎక్స్టసీ బికాస్ షీ వాస్ సో హ్యాపీ వేరింగ్ ద న్యూ శారీ. కలికి తురాయి సహనము నీ సొమ్ము. See, the sarees and the ornaments are, they don't add beauty to your personality, to the ladies. Patience and forgiving nature, that will add to your beauty. That's what Swami said. This is your mother-in-law's experience, Swami told me. Here, mother-in-law means not actually Swami, experienced ladies. They will give you advices. Whether we follow or not, they will be giving continuously. That's what Swami told me. That means ladies should have this patience and forgiving nature, compassion and kindness. In one of the dreams, long back, I think 10 years back, Swami appeared in my vision. He told me that ladies should have all these qualities, knowledge, beauty, intelligence, affection, kindness, compassion. Like that he was going on telling me. Then I said, Swami, why are you wasting your time? You are telling me all these things. I'm not going to talk anywhere. I'm not going to give speeches. Go and tell my husband. He is going to speak everywhere. That's what I said. No, I couldn't understand. After 10 years, I started speaking in Telugu in the beginning. I started speaking in English only in the beginning. When I went to US for my daughter's deliveries, I used to stay there for 6 months, 5 months like that. Those people, those centers, all the centers there are so many centers in US. They used to ask me to speak something about Swami. That time I don't know anything about Swami. But somehow, if they ask me something, I should speak. Then, in the beginning I went there, I was avoiding all the time not to speak. Somehow postponing like that. But one day, the center people asked me to speak in one center. Then I said, I am not holding any position. I am not in the organization, I am not holding any position, not my loving coordinator, our study circle coordinator, our Bhavika's teacher. I cannot speak, I don't have any position. Then they said, no problem, you can speak. Then said, I must get some clue from Swami, then only I can speak. Then that day I came home, I was reading one book. In the first book I got the message. That is Joy Thomas' book. Then she was doing a lot, giving lectures about Swami. And after some time she came to Swami and Swami gave her interview. In the interview, when she entered into the interview room, Swami stared at her, looked into the eyes. She was very much afraid. Why Swami is doing like this? Perhaps Swami may not like giving me speeches like this. She thought like that. Next moment, Swami changed his face and then, no, you are giving nicely. Go on giving lectures everywhere. You are doing it nicely. That's what Swami said. Then she thought that it's a positive answer from Swami. And she's a writer and speaker also. Then I too took it positive and I gave the speech there in the center that day. Then I thought, Swami, you told me that I can give speech. But I don't know on which subject I should speak. That also you must tell me. I don't know anything about that. Then Swami gave me a clue that unity, purity, divinity, three words he told me. He told me three words. Swami, it's very good that you gave me three words, but how to talk about unity, purity, divinity in 1 minute or in 1 second it will be over. How to continue the speech? Then he suggested three stories about that. That was my first experience in US. After that they asked me in so many centers. And Swami helped me, guided me to give so many talks there. And then even before going to US, Swami prepared me for that. 1 year before that, Swami gave me training and so many people used to assemble in that Samadhi. Swami's parent Samadhi is there, opposite to our house. So many ladies from village, they used to come there and they were reading some book about Swami daily that was going on. And then I thought, these old ladies are reading Swami's literature. there will be, if there is somebody to explain and all that, there would, it would be very nice. I thought like that. I used to go to Samadhi to do Namaskar every day to Iswaramma. That day, I don't know why it happened like that, just as a coincidence, I think. Those people came to me and they asked, why can't you explain and tell us something about Swami daily? So then I said, I am very busy, I cannot do anything. No, they were so particular that at least for half an hour I should go there and talk to them. So that's how every day I used to go there. For half an hour in between bhajan time and darshan time in the evening, I used to go there and tell them something. That's how it went on for 1 year before I went to US. Swami gave me the training also. Whatever Swami does, it is ahead of 10 years plan. It's not immediately, we cannot understand anything about this. One day I was sitting in the line and I was so particular that I was suffering from back pain. I thought, I don't want to tell Swami anything about my pain or personal things, because there are so many people who worry Swami already. Why should I worry? Why should I be the... I don't want any thing. I don't want to worry Swami unnecessarily. If it is emergency means, we can go and ask something. But it's. I thought that it's not so important. I was patiently, I was suffering and I was bearing the pain, taking some painkillers and all that. It went on for 3 months. In between, my husband's sister, she came to have Swami's darshan. We both were sitting in the line and Swami came there. I was holding the letter and in the letter I wrote that my sister-in-law has come, please bless her. That's what I wrote in the letter. So I was holding the letter, Swami came there, and then I gave the letter. Instead of telling my sister has come, suddenly I forgot and I told that, Swami, I am suffering back pain. From 3 months I could resist that. When I saw Swami, I could not, but so I told Swami. Then Swami joked at me, give a stick to your husband. Stick to your husband. All the people were smiling at me and I felt so embarrassed. So, but there is some meaning even in that. After when Swami said that word, after that I never had that pain again. It went off. Just like we cannot understand anything at a stage. That means he is giving warning to the disease. He is giving warning to the disease. So one day one lady came to Swami saying that, Swami, I have to go for operation. Then Swami said, go and die. In Telugu they say, go, chau, chau, it's a. That chau means die. Then she felt that, why Swami is telling like that? When I came suffering like this, you should bless me to go for operation. But instead of blessing, Swami said, go and die. After 1 month also she came to Swami. Even then also, still you are not died. You haven't died, still lived. That's what Swami said. Again, she felt so embarrassed. After some time, without operation, she is cured of the disease. So, even the words are so powerful. Even the words of Swami are so powerful. And they are unique and special. And they help a lot. They give, these words of Swami will give messages, will cure our health, will confer wealth and health on us. And they're so powerful. We cannot understand that power. They are unique and they are gems. So one day, so many group of business people came to Swami. They wanted that their business should grow. And they requested Swami, give us something, Swami. We are doing business. It should flourish. So Swami created one coconut and gave to these people. That Swami moved that coconut like this. That coconut made a coins sound inside. So if some coins are there inside, it will make some galgal sound. That coconut made that sound. So Swami told them not to break the coconut till you go to your native place and keep it near the altar. Don't touch it again. Then your business will go automatically. But these people, they could not resist. On the way, they broke the coconut. The Lakshmi came out. Oh, they felt so sorry and came back to Swami again. Swami, Swami, we did this mistake. Please excuse us. Give another coconut. No, I told you not to break it. So you go, I am not going to give. Just like that. So we have to follow the teachings, or we have to follow the word of Swami. Then only we will be able to, whatever is in reserve for us, we can enjoy that. That there is one man by name, he is from our native place, and he is a tobacco merchant. He earned crores and crores of rupees, but after some time he lost everything and he came to Swami. And my husband accompanied him and he brought him to Swami. Then he could get interview, he was so lucky. Swami gave him an interview, and then Swami created one Lakshmi idol, gave it to his wife. And when Swami created that Lakshmi, and then he said not to take out that Lakshmi pendant with chain and pendant Swami gave her, and you should not take it out. That's what Swami told her. So when they went home, and again he got everything he earned, and whatever the debt are there, then he cleared off everything, and he was so happy. When Swami creates anything purposefully, it will become Achaya. If he gives gold, Achaya, no, limitless. It continuously, it will be perishing like anything. If he gives saris, the saris will be like that. Continuously, we will be getting saris. If he blesses our books, or if blesses our speeches, or our songs, or if you are interested in bhajan, if you get blessed by Swami, everything will be like that. No, these things. It's limitless, and it flourishes, and it gives us so happiness also. That's how Swami blesses all the people. So how to thank Swami, I don't understand. But I am not used to give so many speeches in English. I am used to Telugu. If there are any mistakes, please excuse me. How to thank you, the Lord of the universe. The comforts you have given us. We enjoy the comforts and conveniences, the grace bestowed on us. We express my gratitude. Thank you. Thank you, the Lord of the universe. Thank you, everybody.